Hey Art Family, if you like this one, the full-length version's on Patreon.
They are skidful.
Hello Art Family, and thanks of course to all the new subscribers. For this demo, I am sketching on location in Sewickley, Pennsylvania, the fire station right in the middle of town. I'm using an Etchr Slate mini bag and a Saunders Waterford block 140-pound cold press paper. I'm also experimenting lately with drawing with a pink or a lavender or an orange pencil, just to kind of set the stage with really bright colors, because I tend to paint fairly dull. But this painting is going to focus kind of on brighter colors, given that I was trying to take the day to really absorb the last of the beautiful fall weather and the beautiful fall leaves before they all fall down. If you're interested in the specifics on the supplies, the colored pencils I've been using are the Colorray series from Prismacolor, which are really handy. I did this sketch with an Etchr mini slate bag that I've been carrying around for a couple weeks now. It was a very kind gift from my friend Brian at Brian Ashmore Studios, who's also on YouTube. And I love this thing. It packs a lot more supplies than you would think it would carry in it for being a kind of a thin bag. And it's very comfortable over the shoulder and on a tripod. I've really found this thing exceptionally handy. I've been carrying it everywhere lately. I'll probably talk more in the future about kind of customizing with it, but right now I've just been using it as is and I love it. So the main goal with the beginning of this sketch is I want to knock away everything that's white. And I've left big open areas that I know are going to be in shadow that I'm going to vary from ultramarine to burnt sienna here, and then some raw sienna towards the bottom to try to catch where the light is picking up on the bottom. I tilt it up to dry because I'm sketching here in Pittsburgh. It's a very humid city, so it always takes a long time for watercolors to dry. I'm trying to pitch the sky a little greener in this sketch, so I've got a large warm area across the bottom that I used yellow ochre for with a whole lot of water. I preset some big puddles of yellow ochre, and then usually I've been experimenting with phthalo blue to get more greens in my skies because I've been sort of stuck in a rut of using a lot of redder blues like ultramarine in the sky. And so I'm trying to use more greens, and in this case I used horizon blue from Holbein, which is kind of like a phthalo blue with a little bit of white in it, and I found it really handy to just get a little bit more greens in the skies. There's a lot of really rich greens you see in the sky, and I'm trying to lately experiment more with those rich greens and rich pinks you get in the sky. Overall, with that first wash though, my main goal is just to knock everything down from white except what I want to be white, which is almost nothing in a sketch. So you can really be really loose and free in that opening wash with the sketch, because my main goal is just to set the stage here and just knock everything down from white except a couple areas. And now I'm coming back and sort of putting in as confident as possible, putting in the value statement of these major shapes. So with these trees, and I'm not really going to treat them as trees, in fact I'm trying to remove myself and think of them just as circles. They're just general circles, and I try to get a top part of the circle and a side part of the circle, and how my other measurements can size up to that. I'm also using the trees in the background to negative paint the solid shapes of the building, because I painted the building wet into wet, so it was all very dissolved. So I can use that darker tree in the background to give more shape and definition to the building, just the way I'm using the shadow here to sort of give the insinuated shape of these cars and trucks. And cars and trucks are coming and going. Things constantly change when you're trying to paint on location. In fact, after about 15 to 20 minutes, the light's completely different. And after an hour, it's a totally different scene altogether. So I'm trying to just be very concise and confident and simple with my shapes and remove myself from preconceived ideas of what I'm looking at. You can get away with a lot of really simplified shapes, but when people see it within a context of a scene, the brain kind of does the ink blot sort of imaginative, it fills that span. You give people A and C and their brain will formulate B, and you can sort of, there's a lot of wiggle room there to play with color and light and shape and see the minimal amount of information you need to really concisely convey the statement of the scene that you're trying to sketch. And that comes in handy when you're sketching on location, because the light is changing so fast. You have only a little bit of time to get in and get out and really communicate the scene as fast and concisely as possible. So the goal up to this point has been largely to just get these big shapes working and all these relationships kind of working, the light and the dark, and the brick versus the concrete, and making sure that the shapes work. And then I can come in and sort of fine tune the value and also add a lot more intense value to the area that I want to draw focus to, which I thought for me was this bell tower on the top of the municipality building. I really thought that was interesting how it sort of was striking against the gradient of the sky. And so I'm going to go real strong in the value there to try to draw focus there, and I'm going to leave the rest of the image a little more loose, a little more suggested, so it's a little more scattershot of information over the rest of the picture. And I want to try to draw some focus to the sharper value and sharper edges of the top of that bell tower, that sort of silhouette that's created by the sky holes and all the little sort of decorative woodwork around the top of that column. At this point, I'm just stepping back from the picture. Sometimes it's good to sort of take a little break and not look at the image for a minute and then come back to it and with fresh eyes, close one eye and squint, and really try to make sure that those value relationships are working, and does one shape need to be slightly darker or lighter? And I'm also focusing on doing some of those detail work in the bricks, and always remembering that these small pockets often will be warm because they're picking up light that's bouncing around the scene. And I'm also putting in the telephone pole and the wires and some of the tree branches I'm trying to allow to be more organic. A little tip I picked up from Andy Evenson, who I'm a huge fan of, is to flip the picture over to do the telephone wires because your arm curves a little more naturally that way. You get a little more gentle curve that way. Well, that's going to be it for this demo of the Sewickley Fire Station using the Etchr Slate mini bag, which I'm a big fan of. Thanks again, Brian, for that. I hope you got a lot out of the video. I'm always here if you have questions or just want to talk shop or get some encouragement. And I really appreciate you watching. I appreciate the subscriptions. And I'll see you in the next video. In the meantime, happy sketching.